Hello students, I'm again with you for another class of your English speaking, like as you wanted to learn English speaking. Now when we are doing the English speaking classes, you must be wondering, are we really doing English speaking or are we really learning English? So I will say we are not learning English, we are working, we are heading towards to learn how to speak better English. That is the way. If you recall my first sentence, I need to first manufacture a sentence. We have to make that soap in the factory to sell it in the market. So I'm just trying to prepare you for that particular thing, that we have to prepare that soap. So there is no hurry of speaking English. That we will see. See, when you are making cooking something at home, what do? You bring some different ingredients on your table, on the kitchen shelf, and then you start doing it. Doesn't really mean that you just start cooking and then go to the fridge and then you bring something. No, my dear. You keep everything on your desk and then you start doing it. Same is the case here. We just want to bring things on our table. So there is no haste. Though it is an English speaking class, I still say we are not doing exactly speaking, but we are definitely heading towards that particular thing. We are inching ahead in every class. Okay, let's understand what we want to do. I want to start from the last class when I was teaching you present indefinite, if you know. That then we would discuss that we said that this will be subject and V1, if you know. That was the case. Now we have to see what you practiced in last at your home since my last video. You must have practiced, I told you, one day you make sentences in the present, then you make in the negative, then you make in interrogative. You must definitely have made all those things. Okay, I'm just trying to do something with you. Let's practice. Okay, when you said, main khelta hoon, say like that, I have written this sentence. Now for me, I and this play is the sentence. So I say, I made the sentence like this, I play. You must have made a sentence like that only. I play, subject and verb. And then we said this, if you were to make the translation of this sentence, hum padte hain, suppose, so we study, that's it. And then, log traffic rules ka palan nahi karte. Karte means telling you something, it is a routine habit. Now, log, so we say people. And now this is negative sentence. Now, what do you really require with people? Do or does? Now you have to think people is a third person, plural number. It means it requires do with it. So people do not know this. It is follow what? Traffic rules. That's it. That's it. Okay. क्या आपका भाई आपकी मदद करता है, kind of thing, करता है. When I read this sentence, करता है, what do you really understand? It is present indefinite. I'm just thinking in my mind, this is a routine kind of, it is say this particular word is telling me, it is present indefinite. Now, I have to understand, ये क्या चीज है? This is your brother. And hold for a while and think of it, your brother is what person? Your brother is what person? It is not I, it is not you, it is your brother. It means that person is the third person, not I, not you. Your is not telling you you, your is telling you your brother. It means an association. So we say position. So now we say I is the first person, you is the second person, then your brother is definitely the third person. Now, and again, brother is there the case, it means it is a singular. Now, what is the rule? Third person singular, we require S or ES with that. Okay, one. And secondly, we require does with it. Two rule. Now, it is interrogative sentence now. इट मीन्स वट आई रियली नीड, आई रिक्वायर, क्या आपका भाई आपकी मदद करता है. मैं कहता हूँ मैं इसको इंटरोगेटिव से नहीं बनाता हूँ, मैंने ऐसे सोच लिया कि मेरा क्या आपका भाई आपकी मदद नहीं करता है, सॉरी मैं ऐसे बना दिया आपका भाई आपकी मदद नहीं करता है. तो योर ब्रदर डज नॉट हेल्प यू, आई नो योर ब्रदर डज नॉट हेल्प यू, नो आई नो दिस डज इज देयर. नाउ इफ आई टू मेक एन इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस व्हाट विल आई डू, आई विल कम लाइक दिस, डज योर ब्रदर not help you, does your brother not help you, that is what we need to understand now. Does your brother not help you? Why? Your brother does not help you. So does comes out, if you want to make, you can make like this, you make a sentence like this, your brother does not help you. From this does, you bring it out here and then make this sentence, does your brother not help you? Now you can say, doesn't your brother help you? Let's go in step. So we say, doesn't your brother help you? For sure. But abhi right now, for the time being, does your brother not help you? And then we'll make it like this, doesn't your brother help you? Okay? I'm just trying to take you step by step. There's no hurry. We will come to the rule as well. Okay? Now, कुछ लोग चमत्कार की आशा करते हैं. आशा means hope. कुछ लोग some people. Now, चमत्कार की English अगर आपको नहीं आती तो ये आपको लर्न करनी होगी. मिराकल, आप मैजिक भी लिख सकते हैं, बट मैजिक मैजिक होता है, मिराकल मिराकल होता है. ओके, मिराकल मैजिक जादू हो गया, ठीक है, लेकिन मिराकल मतलब जो ईश्वरीय होता है, बड़ा गॉडली काइंड ऑफ थिंग. सो वी डिवाइन, सो वी लेट्स लर्न द वर्ड चमत्कार इज मिराकल. ओके, सो नाउ वी नो दिस सब्जेक्ट, दिस इज योर सब्जेक्ट सम पीपल. व्हाट विल यू से? Some people, now you use the word verb. What was the verb? This hope. Now you say hope and then we say expect. Okay, we can say this also. Both ways. We say hope. Miracles. Now if you say some people hope miracles to happen, then it is a different thing. So instead of using the word hope here, if I use the word expect miracles. And now this is easy. Now suppose you make the word hope, some people hope miracles to happen. So that is a different sentence. Now we want to make it easy. So I said some people expect miracles. So that's what the case is. Some people expect miracles is easy. Now you have made a sentence. Kuch log chamatkar ki aasha karte hain. Simple. Some people expect miracles. That serves the purpose. Okay? Agar hum abhyas karte hain, hum safal ho jate hain. Hindi mein to aisa bolte hain. Agar hum abhyas karte hain, to hum safal ho jate hain. I have not written that word to here. Now, agar hum abhyas karte hain, to agar is what? If we now practice, ho gaya, if we practice, we safal ho jate hain, you can write like that, we get success, or we can say we succeed. You can use it both ways. We succeed. If we practice, we succeed. If we practice, we get success. See, there are many ways to say the same thing. How many words you use is the key. If you use few words to say something, that is a better way of saying. Okay? So we're learning. I'm not trying to compare. I told you with the driver of a Ferrari car. I am not saying, I am not former one driver, I am a learner. Okay, the one who is learning how to ride a bicycle. I am that kind of fellow. I am going that way. Don't worry. You go like this only. You will grow accordingly. It will take time, but it will definitely, you will learn. Now I have made sentences. Now let me go further. What is the next step? You say that we have done this. Some people expect, your brother does not, people do not follow, and then we study and then I play. Now suppose I say I play, मैं ऐसे कहना चाहता था कि मैं रोज खेलता हूँ, so I practice, I play, extend the sentence, every day, so I play you have already made, the next step is every day, कहाँ खेलते हो, तो in the ground. That's it. Every day in May, in the ground. Let's go by this ki May ki Hindi, English in hai. Let's not worry ki woh kabhi kuch aur ho jati hai. Abhi I am not going there. I am just going this way ki May ki English in hai. I play every day in the ground. Kitne baje? 5 baje. To at 5 PM. At टाइम जब भी लगाओ, टाइम के हिसाब से, वेन एवर यू वॉन्ट टू मैंशन टाइम, काइंडली यूज एट देयर फॉर टाइम यू रियली रिक्वायर एट एंड दिस यू रिक्वायर इन. ओके, नाउ व्हाट वी हैव डन, वी हैव एक्सटेंडेड द सेंटेंस, बट द की इज दिस हैज टू बी परफेक्ट. इफ यूर दिस इज ओके, तो आई विल थिंक इन प्रेजेंट. Rest is okay, no problem. You can say I play every day at 5 p.m. in the ground for the time being. Then we need to learn what has to come first, whether we have to place the adverb of time or adverb of position, that we will talk about that. That is a different case. Do not worry. We are speaking. Okay? So we do not have to worry. Adverb of time has to come first or adverb of position has to come. I am not concerned right now. I told you I am a learner. So I am just trying to now extend my learning, that you just part, one part, two part, three part, add on. You may be wrong at times, you may make a mistake. Instead of putting in, you will do on, no problem. Right now you make on, no issues, later you will learn. So at, still you can learn that in case of place we have to use in the ground, and then in case of time you can learn a at is required for time. You can keep in mind. What I'm saying is, even if you make some mistake, do not worry. Okay? So at 5 p.m. Now, we study. What do we study? English, music, dance. So you write down. We study subject, verb, and then object. We study English. When? रोजाना, तो इसे एवरी डे, ठीक है, किससे पढ़ते हो, फ्रॉम अवर टीचर, वी से लाइक दैट, तो फ्रॉम अवर टीचर, कहां पर, क्लास में, तो इन द क्लास, हो गया. तो व्हाट आई डिड इज, we study is the one thing that we made first. Now we made one, English, every day two, from our teacher three, and in the class four, at 7 a.m. five. I'm saying I am not worried what has to come first. I'm just trying to learn how to extend my conversation. Can I convey what I really wanted to without getting fumbled? Fumble means atak jana kind of thing. Aap ay karne lage, aisa nahi hoga. Because now you know. Now you know what you wanted to say. We study English. What? Every day from our teacher in the class at 7 a.m. Perfect. Okay? For the time being, I will say it make sentences extend till my next class. That is the homework. You learn how to extend sentences and that is the case. Now log traffic rule ka palan nahi karte. People do not follow traffic rules. Okay, people do not follow traffic rules. That was the rule. अब आप कहना चाहते हैं और प्रॉब्लम खड़ी करते हैं दूसरों के लिए. पहले हम माने कि प्रॉब्लम खड़ी करते हैं तो क्या करोगे आप? व्हाट विल यू राइट? पीपल डू नॉट फॉलो ट्रैफिक रूल एंड प्रॉब्लम खड़ी करते हैं. खड़ी करना मतलब स्टैंड नहीं लगा सकते, क्रिएट करते हैं ऐसा आप कह सकते हैं, कॉज करते हैं. यू कैन यूज लाइक दिस क्रिएट और कॉज. यू कैन से देन वी से कॉज क्रिएट. यू कैन राइट आल्सो इफ यू वांट. देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम इन राइटिंग राइट नाउ स्पीकिंग क्रिएट. यू कैन स्पीक क्रिएट, यू कैन मेक प्रॉब्लम्स. आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम व्हेन यू राइट लाइक दैट. सॉरी, स्पीक लाइक दैट, नॉट राइट, स्पीक. बट राइट वर्ड इज कॉज. बट व्हेन यू आर स्पीकिंग आई टोल्ड यू सब्स्टिट्यूट. If cause does not come to your mind, do not worry. You start using create, make, no issues. The other person should understand what you're trying to convey rather than you get stuck. Don't get stuck. You have few options with you. It may not be exactly what is required, but it will convey your message. Okay. So what the communication is? Communicate. Communicate means you send your message across in a proper fashion. So that's what we're trying to do. So people do not cause traffic rules and cause. What? Problem. No problem भी कह सकते हैं और you can write the word cause trouble. हो गया. Problem खड़ी करते हैं तो cause trouble, cause problem. अब now you say cause problem तब भी मैं समझ जाऊंगा. And if you say cause trouble, that would be a better sentence. No issues. So people do not follow traffic rules and cause trouble. किसे? दूसरों के लिए problem खड़ी करते हैं तो cause trouble. Two others. आप ऐसा कह सकते हैं, कुछ लोग ऐसा बोलेंगे जी फॉर अदर्स. यू आई से एज फार एज स्पीकिंग गोज, इवन इफ यू मेक ए सेंटेंस लाइक दिस, पीपल डू नॉट फॉलो ट्रैफिक रूल्स एंड क्रिएट ट्रबल फॉर अदर्स, आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम. I have no problem as a beginner. At least I know that I can convey. Though instead of using for, I really need to use to. But if you're speaking, it makes hardly any difference. Because you have to communicate. Okay? Communication is required. And that is required. People do not follow traffic rules and make problem to others. Cause problem to others. Create problem to others. Create a problem for others, no issues. What I learned? I learned how to extend today. I am learning how to extend my learning. That same tense that I learned, I want to make longer sentence. So you feel better. Okay, I can make longer sentences also. What I really need to do is this much, this much, this much, this much. You are adding. Adding with in, at, on, upon, from, whatever it is. That may be wrong here and there. But that we will learn gradually. You can learn that from my grammar classes on the other end. You can go to preposition section. You can learn from there. What preposition is required at what place. Nobody is stopping you from there. So you can learn from there as well. But even if instead of saying to others, if you say of for others, people will not laugh at you. At least they will not make, you will not become a laughing stock. At least you are conveying your thing. Okay? I'm not saying that you have to speak at a conference, but how to speak? That is what the way is. Extend your sentences. Now, kya aapka bhai aapki madad karta hai? To humne bola tha. Does your brother help you? I was saying this. Now I say, kya aapka bhai aapki madad karta hai hamesha? तो हमेशा लिखना होगा तो डज योर ब्रदर हेल्प यू. दिस वॉज द सेंटेंस. क्या आपका भाई आपकी मदद करता है? तो डस योर ब्रदर हेल्प यू? दिस वॉज द सेंटेंस. मैंने कहा कि हमेशा लगाना है, हमेशा. आप इफ यू आर ए लर्नर यू कैन वेरी वेल से दिस, डज योर ब्रदर हेल्प यू ऑलवेज, मे बी लाइक दैट. यू इवन इवन इफ आई से आई विल एक्सक्यूज यू फॉर दैट, इवन इफ यू मेक ऑलवेज हेयर, आई डोंट माइंड राइट नाउ. बट डेफिनेटली द बेटर थिंग इज ऑलवेज हैज टू कम बिफोर द वर्ब. डज योर ब्रदर ऑलवेज हेल्प यू? ओके, बिकॉज दिस इज समथिंग हैज टू कम बिफोर द वर्ब. आई एम नॉट गोइंग एट वर्ब ऑफ फ्रिक्वेंसी और वट एवर, आई एम नॉट गोइंग इन टू ग्रामर राइट नाउ. माई कंसर्न इज इवन इफ आई एम सेइंग दिस टू यू, यू वॉन्टेड टू एक्सटेंड ऑलवेज, ओके, यू कैन से डज योर ब्रदर हेल्प यू ऑलवेज. आई अंडरस्टैंड वट यू वॉन्ट टू कन्वे. नाउ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक इट बेटर इंग्लिश, यू मेक डज योर ब्रदर ऑलवेज हेल्प यू. दैट इज वॉट यू नीड टू लर्न इन ग्रामर क्लासेस. But in communication class, if you know grammar as well, you make a better sentence. That is why grammar learning is important for speaking as well. Okay? That is the difference. When you know better English, you know better grammar, you speak better English. Okay? That is what the case is. That is how you become Shashi Tharoor or you become a better speaker. So if you see these kind of, our finance minister Arun Jaitley was there and he used to speak mesmerizing English. You see, many people, those who are speaking good English, all scholars and all, their grammar is also good. Their vocabulary is good. So their speaking is also perfect. Whatever they want to say, the other person understands the same thing. So always has to come here, but do not bother right now. I do not want to become Shashi Tharoor overnight. But does your brother help you? You are made always. You can bring it here. Does your brother always help you? You learn it. You learn it. Some people, I said, some people expect miracles. Some people expect miracles. So, kya karte hain? Isliye wo mehnat hi nahi karte. Isliye wo mehnat hi nahi karte. Some people expect miracle. Isliye so. आप therefore भी लिखेंगे अभी भी चलेगा. I have no problem. Though so is a better conjunction here, still even if you use the word therefore, I have no problem with this because you're conveying. Some people expect miracles. So वो मेहनत नहीं करते. वो मतलब वे means they. मेहनत नहीं करते, work hard. So they do not do hard work. Someone say they do not do hard work. Okay? They do not mehnat karna. Karna English is do. What? Hard work. Perfectly all right. But if you make the same sentence this way, they do not work hard. If you make they do not what? Work. Now is working as verb. Now work here is working as, this was your verb. Now this is my verb. So they do not work hard. That is a better sentence. Though if you say like this, they do not do hard work, I have no problem if you are speaking. At least you are making a correct sentence that is communicable, the other person can understand you the way you wanted to convey. So some people expect miracles, so they do not do hard work, so they do not work hard. For me both these sentences are correct because you are in a stage to convey what you wanted to say. Okay, I'm just trying to teach you today how to extend your learning part. So they do not do hard work, it is a noun here, but they do not work hard. So they do not, they is subject, do not work hard, it is the verb, and then hard is definitely has to add on to this particular thing, work. I will not go to into this is adjective or adverb or what kind of this thing. Let's forget about that. Now you are extending these sentences. Okay, if we practice, अगर हम अभ्यास करते हैं, इफ वी प्रैक्टिस वी गेट सक्सेस, वी सक्सेड. ओके, परफेक्टली ऑल राइट. Now I come down to this. I play every day in the ground at 5 p.m. Okay? किस लिए करते हो जी? खेलते किस लिए हो? I play every day in the ground at 5 p.m. किस लिए? For what? तो I say to practice. This will be S वाला practice, not कसी वाला practice. You have to say to practice. Okay? We study English to learn. We study English to learn. Okay? We speak to communicate. We come here to study. So this is also you can add on. Let me explain it to you. Hope you have noted down all this. I'll explain you further. So now we have learned how to extend these sentences. I play every day in the ground at 5 p.m. to practice. What for? For a match. Which match? To be played on 1st October between India and Pakistan. You extend this sentence as long as you want, as much as you want. But only thing is, my main sentence is I play has to be good. I am playing is not required here. I was playing is not required. I was played is not required. I required is I play. My basic thing is last class what I told you. I play is the case. So we say I play. We study. They come. Everyone wants. She goes. Okay? Attends. I like that. Now what I want to tell you is, if you learn from preposition, that you have to add in, add upon, that will help you. Don't rush. Go easy. Make shorter sentences. Now you extend these sentences. Now you learn to extend sentences. I know a bit of the preposition. In, on, upon, at, over. That's it. Don't go much into preposition. You don't have to become a master overnight. Just learn the preposition, whatever is required for the time being. Make small steps. If you recall my ripple factor, I'm in no hurry. I can take 365 days in a year to learn English, but the day I go out, I should be able to make a perfect sentence and speak at every speed. I'm in no hurry to speak faster. Let's manufacture that soap. Keep in your mind, make the correct sentence first. Speak it out later. Make the correct sentence. Now what I'm learning is, we study, I play what? I play football, okay? Okay? So I play football to practice, I was saying. This practice is verb. I have to use S here. We study to learn what? English. To learn, to practice. They come here, suppose. So they come here. What for? To dance. Everyone wants to excel, to succeed. To flourish, whatever you want to add, to be better, to be happy. She attends the classes. What does she attend? She attends the seminar, you can say. She attends the classes, you can say. She attends the classes, she attends the seminar. What for? To learn what? English. To learn, to excel, to dance, to learn, to practice. What you need to do is, for the next class, whenever we take that class, I upload that video. For a week or so, your job is now to learn how to extend my present indefinite learning that you did in the last week. Now make short parts and add on to that. Note down all those parts in your notebook. Don't think only in your imagination. Write down this, add on. Make shorter sentences now. But keep this, they come, we study, I play, she attends, everyone wants. Third person singular number, third person plural number, do, does. I am still at present definite. I tell you, if you know present definite well, you have learned 50% of English speaking. Take my word. If you know present definite well, you have learned 50% of your English speaking. Then you are in a stage to communicate. We will add on certain things, we'll make it better. But first learning is this only. Let's learn this. I've told you this. Now one more thing I want to tell you. You really need to read something. You really need to read something simultaneously. That will help you better. Because the reason, if you practice here, whatever you're practicing, if you find this being used somewhere, I think you become a better person. Then you realize, okay, he is using this way, I can use this way as well. I am not saying you go to a grammar book. I am not saying. Don't go to Renan Martin or any other book. We do not require any grammar book right now. But I still say you really need to read something. Read some average book. Read some good book that you have. I can help you reading. I'll tell you a few books that you can read. Okay, give me a second. Yes. This is something for the one who feels, you may be watching this video in any part of the country, okay? You may be in the remote corners, you may be in any metropolitan, or you may be from a college as well. But see, let me tell you one thing. First day we learned the table of 2, and we learned like this, 2 1 the 1, 2 1 the 2, and 2 2 the 4, and 2 3 the 6, and 2 5 the 10. We learned like that. We mugged up. And later when we learned in the class 3 or 4, whenever, that we can multiply and then we can make plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 4 by adding, and 2 into 2 into 2. We learned that as well. And we practiced that shortcut. But first we made the basic. Everyone has learned English like that only. Some people learned because the reason they are from those families and that they were in that kind of environment. So they never realized they learned like that. But now if we are trying to make the sentence, we have made the sentence. Now if I cannot force anyone to speak English around me, what, I can read something. If you find you are very poor at English, if you do not know, I have one of the best examples in my life, that when I taught a person, one of my students, to learn English, you know from where she started. She started from this, you know. I want to show you this book. This is a Champak. Champak, this book we have. This is in English. You can buy, this will be around 50 rupees, I say, in the market. You can buy this book. You can do this. If you can see this, many words you find here. The person, the child has written the meaning here as well. You can write like that. You can read this. If you find it is easy for you, that if you find you can do this, perfectly, all right, this is for the beginner, I say. The one who does not know can go through this kind of book. The person, the student, the one who studied this, has compiled all the champaks at one place, you know. The kind of work the child has done. Okay, and now this child of the student of mine can speak good English and write good English, and then is at a very good place, at a very good position in the society. But what is required? The person started way back, maybe 5 years, 6 years back, started from here only. You can start with champak. It is easy to get hold of it. From where you can get it from the market. It is easy. And those who think that they know how to read that book, for me, the one who wants to learn how to read, I find many such students in my classes, those who cannot really read properly. That is why they are not in a stage to do better reading comprehensions. Okay? Buy this book. This is the 12th class book, Flamingo. NCRT book. You can buy this book from any shopkeeper. You will buy it from any bookstore. This is, it will not cost you more than 50 bucks. And what is required is, you have to buy a book that is there. One paragraph is written in English and then underneath they have given you the translation. English, they have given you the translation. English, they have given you the translation. Now what I want is, I'm not saying that you have to read Hindi first, but first you have to read the English sentence. You have to just hold that, hide that particular Hindi wala section and then read the English sentence. Follow these rules. Can you understand what is he trying to say? Okay, if you do not understand the vocabulary word, I tell you one thing, this guy is this very good that they have written the word meaning here just under the paragraph. You can see they have written the word meaning here under the paragraph. So when you are reading like this, those difficult words are already in bold and then you can see the meaning as well. So it is easy for you to understand what the writer is trying to convey. Keep reading. Do not bother. Even if you do not understand the whole concept of the word sentence, do not worry. But now I am there to read. I am there to read. Reading is also very important. So read that. Now, when you read one paragraph and then you realize, okay, you have read, you have understood. Now remove that paper from the hidden section and then try to read the Hindi. And now you can relate what you understood and what he is trying to convey. I think you will be able to understand, okay, here I was wrong. Okay, here I was wrong. Then what do? We learn in the classes. And when we are doing this English speaking, we are heading towards that. You are attending my other grammar classes. That will also help you. Now we have to read. This is a permanent teacher with you. This is a teacher at your home. You read one sentence and then, okay, this is the meaning. Now you see, is it the meaning? You read one paragraph, wait, remove that paper, see what was the meaning. Now you come to know. Then what will you know? You will know that I have to write the word expect or hope. You will know, you will learn what is the English of miracle. Oh, sorry, Hindi of miracle. So this is what you will learn from the book. To read something parallelly, but don't read a tough book. I've told you two books. Begin, the one who feels that he is very poor at English can follow these classes and then follow a champak, start reading from there. Or if you are good and still you find that you cannot really understand reading comprehension well, I come across many people, you follow this book. This has got 8 chapters in this and I assure you, I guarantee you rather, if you read all these 8 chapters with logic, whatever logic I'm trying to tell you, with logic, I guarantee you after reading these 8 chapters from this book, you will be in a stage to understand a reading comprehension well. Mark it, note it down in your notebooks. You have to read all these 8 chapters the way I told you. After that, you yourself will say you know how to read and then you will be in a stage to do a better reading comprehension. As far as reading goes, and if you're reading, I think you understand how to manufacture a sentence, how to make a sentence, and then you do this. So the agenda is reading something. Agenda is extending the present definite construction sentences. You do this in this week. We'll meet you in the next class. Thank you very much, my dear. God bless you all.